How ready is this country's Special Operations Forces?
I think the United States Special Operations Command is ready for the things that we have been and will be asked to do in the future. And we don't take that lightly, and I don't say that with any amount of bravado here.
We've come to Fayetteville, North Carolina, home to Fort Bragg, home to U.S. Army Special Operations Command. From all of the military services who do some of the most difficult and dangerous work around the world.
We're in 80 to 85 countries, so we're going to go where the nation needs us to go.
Come in. I think I broke my arm. We're leaving right now. We got about 15 minutes to the nearest FST.
We came here for a really extraordinary opportunity to interview General Joe Votel, four-star commander of the U.S. Special Operations Command.
What you're seeing is kind of a situational exercise right here, and in the process of recovering back a casualty, not a real, but a simulated wound that they'll have to deal with, and now you kind of see the medics getting down there. This focus on care at the point of injury is a real, is a significant factor for us. You know, it's one of the kind of the things that we have learned about our profession here. We got to be physically fit, we got to be able to shoot well, we got to be able to execute our tactical tasks, and we got to be able to take care of each other on the battlefield.
Hey Doc, this guy's good to go.
In the real world, when does this training come into play?
Well, it's valuable on objectives when we have people that are wounded. You know, we often talk about that golden hour where within, you know, an hour or shortly thereafterwards of somebody being injured, we want them back in a medical treatment facility.
Pretty realistic.
Very realistic.
Moving.
So you have talked about the gray zone. What is the gray zone?
It's this area in the middle where things are not clear. It's not completely peace, it's not completely war.
Where is the gray zone out there in the world right now?
Well, I think I think a good example is the Ukraine. As we see military organizations, we see
from the Russians.
Yes, we see surrogate organizations, we see ethnic populations being brought to bear, we see the manipulation of information operations and media, we see some cyber activity. So all these things taking place, one of the advantages that Special Operations Forces offers is that the gray zone by definition is a very uncertain environment there. And so one of the capabilities that we provide is with our unique forces, some of which you've seen here, Green Berets and Civil Affairs and our military information support organizations, we can step into those areas and help add some clarity, some understanding to what's going on.
I think especially after the raid that killed Osama bin Laden, a lot of Americans see this as a Hollywood movie, SEAL Team 6, Delta Force. They go in, they find a bad guy, they kill him.
I don't think it's reality at all. I think the vast majority of people that are in this command are focused on the mission and aren't concerned about credit for themselves or credit for their organizations, but are really concerned about accomplishing the mission that the American people expect us to accomplish.
These are some of the toughest guys out there, highly trained, highly skilled, but General Votel will tell you that is not enough.
We're looking for people that are not only physically fit, but they can make good decisions. They demonstrate agility, they demonstrate flexibility, and they are the ultimate problem solvers. When they get into a situation where there is a challenge, they immediately start to work through how do we recover from this.
We've seen them learning how to use their weapons and how to use foreign weapons as well. These forces are not Votel's forces. These forces are the ones he is in charge of training and equipping, and then he makes them available to battlefield commanders around the world.
Great people, they're magnificent.